The difficult boss is, of course, a staple of movies and sitcoms, but as Nightline correspondent John Donvan reports, they are a fact of everyday life as well.
Why the Democrats might be pushing the bad boss button, because practically everyone who's ever gone to work knows how it feels to work for a monster.
What good are you? Do you have a brain? Do you want to keep this job? Shut up, listen, learn.
Not good. That's why we make so many movies about it and TV shows. The landmark TV portrayal, David Clennon as Miles Drentel on 30-something, a boss so sadistically controlling, he never raised his voice.
But I want to know if you tried to sink this idea before it reached the team.
Could we have this discussion in private?
No.
Loud and nasty, that's the only way it sticks, though.
But Kevin Spacey did, as Buddy Ackerman, Hollywood producer, in Swimming with Sharks, a portrayal so sharp and authentic, it's used as a teaching tool by some of the bad boss consultants, a small but growing cottage industry that includes Gary Namie in the state of Washington.
We love Swimming with Sharks because in that little independent movie, Kevin Spacey is probably the prototypical bully.
One further sign that Americans are feeling bad about bad bosses. Here's the stack of books that one of our staffers lugged back this afternoon from the self-help section of a single bookstore in the neighborhood, finding titles like Nasty Bosses, The Bully at Work, How to Work for an Idiot. Clearly, the publishing world thinks it's tapping into something serious.
We all know what that is. It's helplessness.
Now, you've all asked us not to show your faces for obvious reasons.
Courtesy of the Midtown Group, an employment firm here in Washington, this morning I spoke with three women who have in various office settings experienced all of it. Verbal abuse.
And he came out and he was throwing pens around on the ground and cursing.
And hectoring.
But one particular place I worked at, it got to the point that professional help had to come in. A therapist had to come in.
And humiliation, as for instance when the woman in the center cut up an apple for her boss's snack and he didn't get to it right away and he screamed at her when it discolored a little bit.
I had misjudged the timing and therefore it was my fault that the apple was brown. And so
when he screams at you for making his apple brown, you say what?
I'm sorry.
What have all three done in such situations? The only thing they can do if they don't want to put up with it, they quit.
Normally the only right you have is what economists call the exit voice. You can leave and go somewhere else.
14 years ago, when another presidential nominee was accused of workplace abuse, it turned into a national drama. Clarence Thomas survived charges brought by a law school professor of inappropriate sexual comments when he was her superior, and he became a Supreme Court justice.
More than anybody.
But the case changed the way men and women talk to each other in the workplace.
Many employers to take a more serious look at the issue.
TV newscasts were filled with reports of these kinds of training films that suddenly millions of employees were required to watch.
I'm sorry, I'll be out of your way in just a minute.
Don't hurry, I'm enjoying the view.
The discussion surrounding John Bolton's case, whatever the actual facts may be, is not likely to do the same for mean bosses. Sexual harassment is illegal, like discrimination based on race, religion, age, and disability, but harshness is not a crime.
What if I just don't like the way you walk?
I can fire you or otherwise harass you because I don't like the way you walk, unless somehow you walk in a way that's caused by a disability.
Donnell Hiltz, an occupational therapist, and Bonnie McAllister, an insurance agent, both felt bullied at work. Both say their health suffered from it.
I did approach litigation. However, my employer is so powerful in the Northwest. I went to over 30 attorneys, and none of them would help me.
Both women are clients of Gary and Ruth Namie, a married couple who counsel employees who have bullying bosses and who offer advice to companies on how to head off such behavior.
The workplace is just an extension of all of our other institutional lives, and it shouldn't, oughtn't happen. As we say, work shouldn't hurt. Where is it written that for a lousy paycheck, you should actually suffer such debilitating stress that you have a stroke or heart attack?
Namie helped to write some proposed laws in California and Oklahoma to prohibit bullying by bosses and others at work. Those proposals so far have failed, in part because it's not easy to define bullying. there's a difference between being a tough boss and being an out-and-out jerk of a boss. In America, tough can get you a magazine cover, such as this one of Jack Welch, the former chairman of General Electric a few weeks back. He also made his company billions of dollars, which counts for a lot. In fact, whoever you are, make billions. And the truth is that even if you're a jerk, you can probably get away with it. And if your workers don't like it, they can quit. I'm John Donvan for Nightline in Washington.